Hello, guys. I don't know. Not many people talk about these amazing plants, Tolumnias. Here I have two Tolumnia hybrids. This is the basic common one, the gentling pink lady, I think it is. And I have two different ones in here, both from the same breeder, actually. I forget what they are, but like an apple hollow cross. Of some sort. I have their tag, but personally, flowers aren't in bloom, doesn't really matter. Anyways, this one is in spike. I'm really excited. This one has a great habit of sending out more flowers on the end of its spike, like some phalaenopsis do. So don't cut these spikes until they're brown and crusty because you might be surprised at what it will do for you. They develop spikes on their new growth. Usually, this is the new growth right here. Usually, the new growth has to be mature, but on this one's new growth doesn't look that mature to me, but it is still sending out a spike. These two I bought as seedlings last year. This one is spiking off of one of these. This one was in spike when I got it, and it did bloom for me. This one was not in spike when I got it, but it did bloom for me. So I've had really good luck with Tolumnias. And let me tell you what I do. And maybe how. Oh, look how big the new growth is on this. See? This is big adult growth. Why is it not focusing? Okay. And this over here is baby seedling growth. Look at the difference in size of their leaves. I'll only tell you how I care for them. They have a purplish tint to them because they get the max light they could get. They're in a south-facing window, and they're way at the edge of the south-facing window, so they're getting a lot of light pretty much all day, except for today because today is rainy. I live where it's sunny most of the time, so it's pretty much always sunny. In this window, let me show you the window. This is where they normally live. They live right down there, on the edge. Here's some Vanda babies. This window gets pretty warm when the sun's hitting it because it has a little bit of a kind of a greenhouse effect, right? It's one of those growing windows. So the temperature in here can get pretty darn hot. And then at night, since it is in the main downstairs area, it cools down, but not as bad as my upstairs does. Say at night, about 60, maybe 70 in the summertime. So there's a bit of a temperature change, and they are warm in this window. When the sun is shining, I've seen this window get up to 90 degrees. I had a little temperature gauge in here. Let's go back to the plants. So I have them potted in clay, not plastic, clay. Most of my plants are in plastic. Now a lot of my plants have been switched over to semi-hydroponics, but these guys are going to stay in clay. This one is with large bark in clay. I have to water this sucker just about every day. Sometimes I forget to water, and it's okay because they really don't mind drying out. They're almost like succulent plants in a weird way. I mean, look at these leaves. They look like succulents. And you can almost treat them like a succulent plant. And here, I did a little something different. Ooh, it's still moist since we've had so much humidity. So I'm not going to water this. If this doesn't feel crunchy, like normally when I water it, the moss will be crunchy. But today, the moss isn't crunchy, so I'm not watering this. Keeping them in clay pots allows more air to the roots. It also allows a lot, it allows the media to dry out a lot faster. And I find these guys really enjoy drying out. I mean, like, we're talking drying out. I used to have these two on a mount with sphagnum moss wrapped around their roots, and they worked really well on that. I mean, that works totally. But I got sick of looking at it. I didn't like the way the mount looked. It was annoying. It dripped all over the place. So, for convenience, not because they didn't do well, but for convenience purposes, they're in clay pots now. And since these guys were wrapped in sphagnum moss on the mount, I kept them with some sphagnum moss and bark. And they're not complaining. Nope, I got spikes. Pretty excited. Ah, oh, whenever you get spikes, it's like Christmas. So, what more can I say about these guys? I treat them more like succulents than I do orchids. I give them the max amount of light, and they end up getting the max amount of heat. They dry out, and if you forget, if they get like almost bone dry, they don't even care. Yeah. So don't overwater these guys. They don't like it. Highlight, nice and warm. I didn't think I could grow these. I was doing research on them and saw they were from the Caribbean and they needed to dry out and they needed high light and they liked warmth. And I thought, oh God, that's not gonna work. I can give them the high light, but I don't know if I can give them everything else. But I did. And I'll tell you what, these plants, Tolumnias, are the fastest growing orchids, I swear. When I got these guys, they were only 8 months out of the flask and blooming. So they spike easily and consistently and pretty quickly. I think these are my favorite orchids. They grow so fast. And all the other ones take forever, like my path petalums. Takes them over a year to grow some new growth. So, if you get the chance, don't be scared. Try Tolumnias, but keep them dry. Awesome plants. Hope this helped. If you have any questions, just ask.